Hello all. This is Mohammad Hanif from RJKT Basar. Once again, I welcome you to this lab session on digital signal processing. Till now, we have seen how we can generate or how we can write a code for low pass filter, high pass filter, and band pass filter. So first, we have written the code for low pass filter. After making small modifications in that same code, we are able to generate high pass filter and then band pass filter. So this is the code for band pass filter. If you have seen my previous videos, you will understand how we have written this code. So I am once again running this code today, and then making small change in this program, we'll try to design a band reject filter. Okay, so shall we start? So first of all, I'm running this same program once again. So this is the code which we have done previously for band pass filter. So here you can see that it is having two cutoff frequencies, FCL and FCH. Okay, and then first we have written the program for a low pass filter, and then we made a change here to convert that low pass filter into a band pass filter. Okay, so I am running the same program now. So first it is asking for sampling frequency. As here you can see that in the code line 4, we are asking for the entering the sampling frequency. The same here we are asked here, so we are entering this, and then we are asking for lower cutoff frequency. As we are, this program is written for band pass filter, so it will be asking two cutoff frequencies. One will be a lower cutoff frequency and another will be upper cutoff frequency. So lower cutoff frequency here I am giving 1000, and then upper cutoff frequency I'll give 3000. Okay, now as we are designing FIR filter, so we have to give one odd number. So here I am giving 51. You can see that this is the band pass filter characteristics. So here, and again, it is asking for to enter the first signal frequency. So here in this our program, after writing this program, we have included two signals. So here you can see that in line 57, we are asking to generate two frequencies. So here the first signal, whatever the frequency you want to give, you can give. So here we can see in our program, we have mentioned lower cutoff frequency 1000 and 3000. In between any frequency in these two, then that will be passed without any error or without any attenuation, and then frequency beyond these two or below these two frequencies, that will be attenuated. Okay, so here first we'll give frequency as 1500. That means this one will be passed, and next I'm giving 500. Here you can see that the characteristics. This is the first signal, frequency of 1500, and then individually we have written for this filterization for each and every signal. And this is the first signal X1, and here you can see that it is not attenuated. The same magnitude can be observed here, and whereas this one, second signal is 500, which is below the cutoff frequency. See, 500. Okay, that means this signal will be attenuated. So here you can see that this is a 0.004, and then the combination of x1 and x2 here you can see. And then out of these two signals, as the 1500 signal is it is in between the band pass filter, so that means it will be attenuated. Okay, so we have successfully generated the band pass filter. So now today we'll try to make band reject filter by making a small change. Okay, so I'll try to explain the each and every line once again. So these three over, and then entering the sampling frequency, and this is sampling period. So here it is asking for two cutoff frequencies, lower and upper cutoff frequencies. And here what we have done is we have converted this analog frequency into digital frequencies, and then from here, we have written the code for impulse response for low pass filter. So this is the low pass filter impulse response of for h of n, and then we have converted this low pass filter into band pass filter by making changes in h. So now we'll change this one. So here how we can change band pass filter to band reject is simple. The simple thing is that you can subtract the band pass filter from all pass filter. That means now h of c can be subtracted from, okay, h of c minus 1. So this minus 1 is indicating the delta of n. The delta of n means it is a all pass filter. Okay, so this is conversion of band pass filter to band reject filter. Okay, that's it. Now if we run this program, so here as we have subtracted this, so we will be getting the 180 degrees of phase shift. So making that change here, h is equals to minus h, will do once again 180 degrees of phase shift. Okay, now we run this program. So asking for sampling frequency, I am giving 8000. Lower cutoff frequency, as it is, we shall go with the previous ones, that 1000 and 3000. Okay, once again the filter size, taking the 51 as it is. Now here you can see that this is the characteristics for band reject filter. Okay, now we'll try to give first signal. So let's 500. That means this signal is not available in between the our two cutoff frequencies. That means it will not be rejected. That means you are going to get this signal as it is. Okay, and then second signal, that's I am giving 1500. Here you can see that these are the outputs. This is the first signal, 500, which is not available in the two cutoff frequencies. That means it is not attenuated. And the second signal is x of 2, which is we have given for 1500 frequency. That you can see that it is attenuated, and the magnitude for this is 0.004. And then this is the combination of these two signals. And then here you can see that we have able to got this 500 frequency. Okay, so this is the output for band reject filter. Hope you understand this. We shall meet in another video. Okay, thank you.